Dear students, let us discuss about transistors. These are two different type transistors. In laboratory, you will get these two type of transistors. We call the transistor as a bipolar device because it uses both electrons and holes as charge carriers. And it is a semiconductor device consisting of three areas. That means NPN, N region, P region, and again N region, or NPN type. That is N. In the case of a transistor, we know that one P type is sandwiched between N type, or N type is sandwiched between two P type. So that is a basic transistors, NPN and PNP. So this is a basic form of a transistor, basic structure of a transistor. It has three terminals. This is first terminal, emitter, base, and collector terminals. So it may be an NPN type where two N region and a P region is in between, or a P region is sandwiched between two N regions. We know that electrons are the majority charge carriers in N region and holes are the majority carriers in P region. Here, this is known as the emitter and this is known as the base and this is known as the collector region. So, this is a three-layered structure. It have two similar layer and an opposite layer in between them. So this is the basic structure of a transistor. NPN means two N layers. A P layer is sandwiched between two N layers. Here PNP means an N layer is sandwiched between two P layers. So first terminal is known as emitter. Emitter, and the function of the emitter is to emit the charge carriers. It is a heavily doped and a moderate size. So the emitter is the heavily doped region in a transistor. It is of a moderate size. And what about collector? This is collector. As its name indicates, collector will collect the charge carrier. So this is the collector and here this is the collector. They are moderately doped. Collectors are moderately doped and it is of large size. So this is the largest size region in a transistor. Collectors are large in size. Emitter is moderate size and it is heavily doped. And collector is moderately doped, and base region is very thin and it is lightly doped. It is smaller in size. So this is an NPN transistor. So this is the symbolic representation of an NPN transistor. So this is here NPN. So arrow mark, this is an arrow mark that is going outside from this device. So this is here. There is an arrow is in the inward direction in the case of a PNP transistor. That is the difference between the symbolic representation of NPN transistor and PNP transistor. So what is a biasing of a transistor? Biasing is an important factor that will decide the function of the transistor. So, if transistor operations are controlled by proper biasing. Biasing is nothing but the way of giving the potential or potential to the transistor. The way of connecting batteries to a transistor is known as biasing. So, a transistor consisting of two PN junctions. Here, this is a PNP transistor. Here, there is a PN junction. And here also a PN junction. So a transistor consists of two PN junctions, and that is emitter base junction and base collector junction. The two PN junctions are emitter base junction. So this is first p-n junction. This, then second one is base collector junction. This is the second p-n junction. Same as in the case of an npn transistor also. This is first p-n junction, that is emitter base p-n junction, and the second p-n junction is base collector p-n junction. So a transistor have two p-n junctions. Then the proper voltage given to the transistor is known as the biasing. The emitter base junction is always in the forward biased condition. And for the proper working of a transistor, emitter base junction should always forward biased, and the base collector junction should always in reverse biased. So this is the collector base junction. So this should be in reverse biased. Emitter base junction, this should be in forward biased. Oh, here also this should be in forward biased, and this should be in reverse biased. So this is a symbolic representation of an NPN transistor. Sorry, this is PNP transistor and this is NPN transistor. What is meant by forward biasing? The P terminal is, emitter terminal is connected to the P. Here emitter is P. P region is connected to positive terminal. So this is forward biased. And here, and in the case of a PNP transistor, emitter base junction should be forward biased. That means the emitter means the P region is connected to positive terminal and N region is connected to negative terminal. So this is in forward biased. And base collector junction is reverse biased, means the collector region, that is P region, should be connected to the negative terminal. Here also it is negative terminal. And this is base junction, that is N junction, that is connected to the positive terminal. So this is reverse biased. So in this picture, emitter base junction is forward biased and collector base junction is reversed biased. So this is the proper biasing of a transistor. It is same, the operation is similar in NPN transistor also. Here N region is connected to negative, so it is forward biased. P region is connected to positive terminal, so it is also forward biased. So this emitter base junction is forward biased and the collector base junction, collector is N, so it is connected to the N region is connected to positive terminal, so it is reverse biased. Here also P is connected to negative terminal, that is in reverse biased. So emitter base junction is forward biased and base collector junction is in reverse biasing. So here also you may notice about this batteries. Here a small positive potential or small voltage is needed to make emitter base junction forward biased, and large a high voltage is needed to make a collector base junction a reverse biased, because there are three batteries are connected in this figure. This is only one battery. So in order to get proper biasing, emitter base junction should be forward biased and collector base junction should be reverse biased. Here listen, this current I is notated for the IE for emitter, IB means base current, IC means collector current. So this is an input voltage, or it is the forward voltage, which is known as VEE, and the reverse voltage, reverse output voltage, that is VCC. So this is the, let us discuss about the operation of a PNP transistor. Here this is a positive potential VEE, here this is positive potential, and it is repelled by the holes in this region, P region. Holes are the majority carriers in the P region. They will move to the collector through the base region. So in the base region, a very low percentage of holes recombine with electrons in the N region, and it provides a low current, which is known as the base current. And the holes reached here, the P region, and an electron from this terminal reaches here to combine with the holes percent reached here. Okay, so there is a hole current inside the PNP transistor, but when you examine the outside circuit, here the current flow is due to electrons, because this is a positive terminal. Electrons are here, minority carriers are here, they will move towards the positive potential and it is reached here. So the current will be in the opposite direction. So I is in opposite direction to the flow of electrons. So I will be in this direction. So here some holes are combined with the electrons here. As a result of that, electrons will be go towards the base region. So the current will be in the opposite direction, that is IB here. So here large number of holes are appear here. As a result of this, electron will flow from the negative terminal to the collector. This will constituting a collector current in the opposite direction. So this is the collector current. So IC and this is IB. IC plus IB. When you apply the Kirchhoff current law in the loop, the current reaching in a junction is equal to current leaving the junction. So IB and IC are reaching here, and the current which is flowing outside is IE. So IE is equal to IB plus IC. From Kirchhoff current law, the algebraic sum of the current reaching the junction is zero, or we can redefine it as the total current entering to a junction is equal to total current leaving the junction. So the total current entering this junction is IB plus IC, and the total current leaving the junction is IE. So IE is equal to IB plus IC. So the collector current is always less than the emitter current, because IC plus IB is equal to IE. So the collector current and base current is always less than the emitter current. ഇവിടെ എന്താ സംഭവിക്കുന്നത് വെച്ചാൽ, ഇപ്പം ഈ റീജിയനിൽ ഹോൾസ് ഉണ്ട്, മെജോറിറ്റി കാരിയേഴ്സ് ആയ ഹോൾസ് ഉണ്ട്. അപ്പൊ എന്ത് സംഭവിക്കുന്നു, ഈ പോസിറ്റീവ് പൊട്ടൻഷ്യൽ ഉണ്ടാകുമ്പോൾ ഹോൾസ് ഇവിടുന്ന് റിപ്പല് ചെയ്ത് ഈ കളക്ടർ റീജിയനിലേക്ക് എത്തുന്നു. കളക്ടർ റീജിയനിലേക്ക് എത്തുന്നതിൻ്റെ ഇടയിൽ ബേസിൽ ചില ഫ്രീ ഇലക്ട്രോൺസുമായി കമ്പൈൻ ചെയ്യുന്നു. അപ്പൊ ഇവിടെ ഉണ്ടാവുന്ന ഇലക്ട്രോണിന്റെ കുറവ് വിൽ റീപ്ലേസ്ഡ് ബൈ ദ ഇലക്ട്രോൺ ഫ്രം ദിസ് ജംഗ്ഷൻ. സോ ദാറ്റ് വിൽ കോൺസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ട് ഐ ബി. And the holes reach here. We would holes it too. This holes, after holes means holes increase. Even though, that is neutralized here. Maybe electrons are flowing from the negative terminal is here. Abhi negative terminal electron come and combine together with the holes here. Abo electrons are flowing in this direction and the opposite direction. Like current, that current is known as IC, and this current is known as. Abhi would holes nashtapadumbo. ഇലക്ട്രോൺസുകളുടെ എണ്ണം. ആക്ച്വലി ദ ആറ്റം ഇസ് എ ന്യൂട്രൽ, എനി ആറ്റം ഇസ് എ ന്യൂട്രൽ ആറ്റം ആൻഡ് ദ മെറ്റീരിയൽ ഇസ് ന്യൂട്രൽ. അപ്പോൾ ഇവിടെ ഹോൾസ് അവിടെ പോകുമ്പോൾ അവിടെ എക്സ്ട്രാ ഇലക്ട്രോൺസ് ഉണ്ടാവും. ദേ വിൽ കം ടുവേർഡ്സ് ദ വി ഇ. അപ്പോൾ അതുകൊണ്ട് ഇതിലൂടെ ഒരു ഇലക്ട്രോൺ ഫ്ലോ ഇങ്ങനെ ഉണ്ടാവും. ഇലക്ട്രോൺ ഫ്ലോയുടെ ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് ആയിരിക്കും കറണ്ട്. അപ്പോൾ ഐ ഇസ് ഇൻ ദിസ് ഡയറക്ഷൻ. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ വർക്കിംഗ് ഓഫ് എൻ എൻ പി എൻ ട്രാൻസിസ്റ്റർ.